Hello everyone, welcome to Geetam Insight Prep Series. In this particular video, we are going to talk about equations. Equations, in general, is a statement in which two mathematical expressions are equal. In this video, we are going to talk about linear equations and quadratic equations. So let's discuss about what are linear equations. An equation in which the highest power of a variable is 1 is called linear equations. The highest power is also called as degree of the equations. Some of the examples of linear equations are 2x minus 3 is equal to 7. In this particular case, as we can see, x is a variable and it has a power of 1. And in the whole equation, that highest power is 1. Hence, this equation is known as linear equations. Second example that we have is x minus 2y is equal to 4. Here, there are two variables, which is x and y, but overall, the highest power of the equation is 1. And hence, it is also a linear equation. Now, let's discuss about various types of linear equation. So the first one in the list that we have is linear equations in one variables. We need to find the solution of 2x minus 3 is equal to 7. Now, this is the equation we have, 2x minus 3 is equal to 7. As we can see, in this equation, we have one variable x and it has a power of 1. So this is a linear equation, but it is a linear equation with one variable because it has only one variable. Now, what are solutions? Solutions are basically the values of variable, the value of variables. How to find the solution of any given equation? Let me just rewrite the equation. Now, I'm going to add 3 both the sides. Why? Then only I'll be able to cancel 3 from the left hand side and I'll be left with only x term. So 2x, we got it as 10. X will be 10 by 2, 5. So since we are getting x value is 5, that means that is the solution of the given equation. Remember, if we have one variable and it is a linear equation, that means we'll be having only one value. Let's move to the second kind of equation, which is linear equations in two variables. Here, the equation that we have, x minus 2y is equal to 4. Here we have two variables. First variable is x, second variable is y. In this kind of equation, we can have infinite number of solutions. How? Let's see this diagram. Now, when I put x value as 0, let us put x value as 0. Then what will be y value? Minus 2y is equal to 4 and y is equal to 4 by minus 2 minus 2. Similarly, if you put y is equal to 0, x will be 4. If you put x is equal to 2, y will be 1 minus 1. And if you put y is equal to 1, x will be 6. So this pair of x and y are known as the solution of the given equation. How do we write the solutions? In the form of x, y. So if I'm going to write these two values, I'm going to write it as 0, comma, minus 2. 4, comma, 0. 2, minus 1. 6, 1. And these four values are not the only possible solution of the given equation. It can be till infinite. I hope it is clear. Let's move to the third kind of linear equations. So in the previous question, we had only one equation which was having two variables. But now we are having pair of linear equations in which we have two variables. Here we have given two equations. First is x plus 6, x plus y is equal to 6, and x minus y is equal to 4. So let me just write it. In order to solve this particular pair of equation, we need to either add or subtract both the equations. Before that, whenever you are having two equations with the same variables, those two sets of or those two pair of equations are known as simultaneous equation. Let me just give the equation numbers. This is the first equation, this is the second equation. What I'm going to do, I'm going to add both the equations. So x plus y plus x minus y is equal to 6 plus 4 plus y minus y got cancelled. X plus x 2x and 6 plus 4 10. So x will be equal to 5. Once you got x is equal to 5, you can put this x value in any of the equation. Let's say I'm putting in equation number 1. So it will be 5 plus 1 is equal to 6. Oh, sorry, 5 plus y is equal to 6. So y is equal to 1. So the solution of the pair of the linear equations is 5 and 1. Now, there are different kinds of pair of linear equations in two variables possible. Let's see what are those possibilities. Here, the first set of equation is a similar case as we just did. So let's quickly find out the solution for this given equations. I'm going to add both the equations, x plus y plus x minus y. 10 plus 2, 12. Y got canceled. X plus x, 2x is equal to 12 and x will be 6. Once x is 6, we can put x in any of the equation and we can get y is equal to 4. So we are getting one fixed value of x and one fixed value of y. That means this equation has unique or only one solution. Now, coming to the second set of equations, instead of adding or subtracting both the equations, we are going to use the substitution method. So from the equation number 1, we can take the value of y. Y will be equal to 2x minus 1. That means I shifted the y to the right hand side and I shifted the 1 to the left hand side. Now I'm going to put this y in the second equation. So 6x minus 3, 2x minus 1 is equal to 3. Open the brackets, 6x minus 6x plus 3 is equal to 3. Now as we can see, plus 6x minus 6x got cancelled and 3 is equal to 3. What does it mean? It means that this equation is true for any value of x and y. That means this pair of equations has infinite solutions. Let's move to the third kind of equations. X plus 2y. From here, I'm going to take the value of x, which is 4 minus 2y, and I'm going to put this value of x in the second equation. So 2 into 4 minus 2y plus 4y is equal to 12. Open the brackets, 8 minus 4y plus 4y is equal to 12. Plus 4y minus 4y got cancelled and 8 is equal to 12. Now, is it possible that 8 can be equal to 12? It's impossible, right? That's why this set of equation has no solution. Because it is an impossible case of 8 is equal to 12. So these are the three sets of equation which have three different sets of or three different types of solution. The first two pair are known as consistent equations. Why they are known as consistent equation? Because they have at least one solution. But the last pair, since it does not have any solution, it is known as inconsistent equation. Inconsistent equation. Here we solved all the equations and we tried to get the value of x and y. But even No, even by not finding the value of x and y, we can tell whether a pair of equation is consistent or inconsistent. How? Let's see. So whenever I talk about two pair of equation, they are basically in the form of a1x, b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, or a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. Now, in order to check whether a pair of equations are consistent or inconsistent, what we can do? a1 by a2, if it is not equal to b1 by b2, that means the set of or the pair of equations are consistent and has a unique solution, and the graph for which looks like the first graph. Second one, if a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 but not equal to c1 by c2, that means that equation, the pair of equation, is inconsistent and will have no solution. Third one, if a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2, that means the pair of equation will be consistent and will have infinite many solution. As we can see in the third graph, both the blue and purple line are overlapped. So these are the three conditions for the three kinds of solution that we saw in the previous slide. So this is all about linear equation. Let's jump to the second kind of equation, which is quadratic equations. Any equation in which the highest power of the variable is 2 is known as quadratic equation. The standard format of quadratic equation is given as ax square plus bx plus c, where a is a coefficient of x square, b is a coefficient of x, and c is a constant. In general, we will call a, b, c as terms. In this, the values of x are known as either solution of the equation or the roots of the equation. Now, these roots of the equation can be of different nature. What are the different nature of these roots? Let's discuss. In order to find the nature, we have something known as discriminant. This discriminant will tell us what nature any particular equation or any root of any particular equation has. This discriminant is given by D, and D is equal to B square minus 4AC. So let's talk about X square minus 5X plus 2. I'm going to compare this equation with AX square plus BX plus C is equal to 0. So what will be A? A will be 1, B will be minus 5, and C will be plus 2. Put this A, B, C in the discrimination. So minus 5 square minus 4 into 1 into 2, which is 25 minus 8, which is 17. Case number 1, whenever D is greater than 0, the roots of the equation will always be real and distinct, means different. Second case, again, we are going to compare this equation with AX square plus BX plus C is equal to 0. A is equal to 3, B is equal to 2, and C is equal to 1. In order to find the nature of the roots, we'll find the discriminant, which is given by B square minus 4AC, which is 3 square minus 4 into, I'm so sorry, 2 square minus 4 into 3 into 1, which is given by 4 minus 12. Which is minus 8. Case number 2, whenever D is less than 0, roots will be imaginary. It will not have any real roots. Case number 3, Again, let's compare this equation with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. A will be 1, b will be 2, and c will be again 1. In order to find the nature, we'll find discriminant. Let's put the value of b, which is 2 square minus 4 into 1 into 1, which is 4 minus 4. D will be equal to 0. Case number 3. Whenever we have d is equal to 0, roots are going to be real and both the roots will be equal. Every quadratic equation will have only two values or two roots, and when d is equal to 0, roots will be real as well as equal. Now we talked about the nature of the roots, but how to find the roots? Let's see. So here I have an equation which is x square minus 5x plus 6. We'll see the method number one first. Method number one is a splitting method in which we will split the middle term in such a way that its sum should be minus 5x and the product should be 6x square. So I can break this number as minus 3x minus 2x plus 6 is equal to 0. We can take x common from the first two terms. So x minus 3 will be inside the bracket. Minus 2 common, again x minus 3 inside the bracket. X minus 3 common and x minus 2 remaining is equal to 0. Now we can individually compare the expression x minus 3 and x minus 2 with 0 and we can get the value of x. So x minus 3 is equal to 0, we'll be getting x is equal to 3, and x minus 2 is equal to 0, we'll be getting x is equal to 2. So these are the two equation or two roots of the given equation. Second method that we have is a formula method, which we call it as quadratic formula as well. Quadratic formula is given by minus b plus minus b square minus 4ac by 2a. How will we get abc? By comparing this given equation with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So after comparing, a will be equal to 1, b will be equal to minus 5, and c will be equal to plus 6. Let's put the values. Minus of minus 5 plus minus minus 5 square minus 4 into 1 into 6 divided by 2 into 1. Minus of minus 5 plus 5 plus minus 5 square is 25 and 6 into 4 is 24 divided by 2, which is given by 5 plus minus 1 divided by 2. Now, since we have two signs, by taking plus sign, we can get one value of x, which is 5 plus 1 by 2 is equal to 3. And if we'll take minus sign, we'll get another value of x, which is equal to 5 minus 1 by 2, which is 2. So again, we got two values of x, which are known as the roots of the given equation. So these are the two methods of finding the roots of any quadratic equation. I hope you have learned everything about linear equation and quadratic equation. That's all for today's video. Thank you so much.